a group of very intriguing artifacts were introduced to the world. Found in Ecuador, a set of 12 cups made from solid jade, all of different size, yet when the bigger jug's contents is poured between the smaller cups, it fills them perfectly. The jug is highly magnetic, but only on the inside. This should be a physical impossibility. When the jade cups are examined under ultraviolet light, they too reveal different star constellations on each cup. They are also numbered, in a language that is known as Sanskrit, an ancient language claimed to predate the Aztecs. Along with the cups, a very strange looking serving plate, with very strange formations of unknown function on the top, and maybe the most intriguing of all, what appears to be an Illuminati pyramid, with 13 steps and an all-seeing eye, was found in the same location. On the base of the pyramid is also the constellation of Orion, along with an inscription in Sanskrit, the translation of Professor Kurtz Childman read, "The Son of the Creator comes." Who made these cups? And who used them? It is not a large leap of the imagination to speculate that these jade cups were connected to some form of alien activity, 12 cups each showing a different star system in black light, which show evidential traces of a magnetic liquid which they contained sometime in the distant past.
That's the so-called World Stone Map. We found it in the year 2000 in a private collection with other 350 pieces. This stone and the other artifacts were found in the year 1984 by engineer Sotomayor while he was in charge for gold digging for a British mining company. He found a tunnel system and in there were those 350 pieces. This stone is about 350 kilos in weight. It's granite and it has a natural quartz line, which you see here, but all the other things are incarved. And for example, it starts here on this side. You can see that there is an eye inlay. This is the area of approximately Israel or the Near East. From here, you can see Italy, Greek. The quartz line, the natural quartz line, goes over the Mediterranean, enters here into the Atlantic Ocean, and here you have one continent which does not exist in our days, and I think this shows Atlantis. Then it enters into South America, and here is another, this is the Bay of Guayaquil in our days, and here you have another inlay and another one going up. And here is a circle inlay, and that's exactly the place where all those pieces were found. And I asked myself many times why here, around this area where the Sumerians were living, you have an inlay of an eye. And there's another continent here on this map, here, that's next to Asia, that's from the northeast Japanese island down further than Taiwan. And Professor Kimura told me, and he wrote also a book about the sunken continent Mu, that he thinks, because of his research, that from the northeast island of Japan, now Russia, until far under Taiwan, there once existed a long continent, and you have it here. And that means that this stone map should be at least older than 10,000 years, but then the big question, how could somebody make such a perfect map already 10,000 or more years before our time? This is a close-up. You can see here Iraq, Saudi Arabia, the Mediterranean, and the eye inlay, the long continent here, and this eye. And here again, the line coming down here and the inlay where the pieces were found, here where the circle is. This is the so-called pyramid with the shining eye. It is a very, very famous, but also very, very old symbol. And this is the only existing really pyramid with the eye. It has exactly 13 steps, like the pyramid on the $1. And very strange, our exhibition where I showed this pyramid in original in Vienna, the opening was on 21st of June 2001, and this crop circle appeared in Eastfield in England on the 21st of June 2001. The strange thing with this one and other artifacts found in Ecuador that if you put black light on it, the eye shines really very, very strong, and the natural color is kind of light green and gray. And the most impressive for me was that on the bottom of the pyramid, you have here in gold inlays the Orion constellation and an unknown